Well, happy Saturday, guys, and happy weekend. Welcome back to another vlog. It's been a while since you see this weird face on the channel. It's because I didn't make any videos. Even though I've been through a few events, I didn't make any videos about them because I was just too lazy to do it. And yeah, so let's leave all that behind. Okay, so we're going to Mines Exhibition Center today to create some content, obviously, and take some pictures. It's a Velocity Motor Show, and basically there will be a lot of cars, I think, coming from local, and also the ones coming from Thailand as well. So we're gonna go over there, we're gonna do some coverage of it, make some videos, and there might be some interesting cars over there. I'm not too sure yet, I've only seen it online, so stay tuned for that, and I'll catch you guys in a bit. Alright, quick little stop before we go on to our destination in Mines. Just gonna get some petrol at the petrol station. Son of a gun, where's this guy going? I can't really tell. Alright, so because of the reading, it's 74 kilometers in range. It only has one bar. I don't trust the reading because 1 second you think it's 74 kilometers. The next second you can see that it's just blank. It's empty. So I don't trust the reading. So I'm gonna stop by and fill up with some petrol, and then we'll be on our way. Alright, we're good to go. And let's head out to our destination. Okay, so we just made it to the event location, which is the Mine Exhibition Center. And we're gonna prepare the camera. Oh shit, I'm gonna lock the door. God. Why did I even lock the door? Why? Yes. Prepare the stuff. So if you guys haven't catch up yet, I have actually not done anything to the car other than paint the front grille and fog lamp covers black, and I also got a front windshield banner, you know, just so that I can be recognized if I ever go to any events or anything like that. Okay, so give me a sec. Yeah, so we have made it to the event location. It's kind of noisy because of the music playing in the background, but there's some interesting cars on the outside as well. And wow, okay, I'll make my way through to get the ticket because you have to buy a ticket first. Yeah, so we're just gonna go zigzag around this place and buy the ticket. Didn't get, is it? Got my thing that you put around the hand thingy, and we're gonna start off from the outside first lah, before we go in. Check out the cars over here, and first off, we're starting with a Satria GTI R3. I have no idea. Looks, I think it's a R3 GTI thingy. Nicely done, clean. I like the like the fitment setup on it. Yep. And I like the wheels too. Pretty much nicely done carbon fiber front hood with the front. I think this is a R3 skirting, so for this kind of Satrias, I'm not really too sure about it. We have a few other Satrias as well, which I'm gonna get to it as well. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go take pictures. So one thing about this camera is that the freaking autofocus is not working anymore. So yeah, I'm gonna have to put you guys down for a moment while I take the pictures. Alright, so we've just taken a few pictures of the cars that are outside here, and moving on to the next, we have this blue Satria Neo with a massive wing at the back, carbon fiber bonnet. There's a cute little sticker for Boost, and black RPF 1 wheels on the car with some nice, I think, semi-slicks if I'm not mistaken on this car. I have a front hood which is also carbon fiber, and this car is fully built as well. I've seen the engine bay of this and it's quite good. And we have most of y'all know whose car is this. This one belongs to Narok, the owner of Narok Garage, and this is a monster build of his car. And look at the size of the turbo on that. HKS turbo. And he has a Mitsubishi Mi-Vec engine. I'm not really too sure the model of this. I'm not good at technical stuff of this thing, but what do I know is that he built this like a custom build, like, so it's the whole thing is the other way around. Okay, this thing is supposed to be at the back, that thing is supposed to be in front, and that's the exhaust which spits massive flames on it. And I like the camo carbon fiber green touch that he has on here. And he has a P1 wheels as well. He has these fenders, custom made carbon fiber bits everywhere, inside, outside the car. Massive wing at the back as well. This is one of the best Neos that I've seen so far. Custom back bumper, custom every single thing. Okay. And yeah, that's the hood. It's also covered in green camo carbon fiber as well. And you have the exhaust cut out for the exhaust. Because race car, why not? And we have another Neo over here, which has some R3 looks on it. The R3 front skirting, carbon fiber camouflage black hood, and it's a nice gun metalish color to the car. I'm not really sure the color is. Carbon fiber side view mirror, and a nice small ducktail looking spoiler in the rear, carbon fiber bonnet as well. Oh, it says Camp Pro Fighter. Okay, yeah. I was trying to figure out what it says. But it looks nice, looks clean, looks good. I think this is custom as well. This is custom fender with the vents. I really like the wheel. The wheels is also a RPO1 end case. Looks nice. Custom grille in front. And we have here I believe this is a Mitsubishi lah. Custom fenders, custom body kit, everything white body. Nice dark blue. Look at the aggressive rear diffuser there, the exhaust coming out. Massive wing. I like. Yep. Huge front splitter and canards. Awesome build.
Alright, moving on to the next. We have what I think over here are this track cars. And it's a Daihatsu, I think. Oh god, I suck at all this, like, naming these cars which I've never seen or never known about. Look at this. This is a Charade, if I'm not mistaken. Daihatsu Charade. It has a... basically, no interior because it's a race car. Only one driver seat. Fully built. Lightweight. And we have a Suzuki Swift as well, which also it's caged and sorry you can't see inside, no interior, and a Vios, which is also a race car, fully built, caged up, driver seat, no interior, no back seats, no nothing. Alright, let's head on to the other side of the hall before we go inside to show you the other cars. Okay, starting off right from the back. Way back. So we have a Canary green color, which is also converted into a Japanese version, into a Daihatsu look. Okay. All the Japanese Automotive Federation stickers, the side view mirror, Japanese style, interior everything, Daihatsu steering wheel, small rear view mirrors, mimic the Japanese look. Those are speakers. Those are the speakers. Okay. This one has a ladder at the back. Have all the speakers at the back here, you can see. Nicely done. And also those Japanese style rims as well. And moving on to the next, we have a... Wait, let me just double check on this first. Yep, that's legit. This is a Daihatsu. It's not a Myvi. It's actually a Daihatsu. It's actually a Japan original Daihatsu car, as it says on the Rotax. Some of you are thinking, oh, it's just a Myvi converted into a Daihatsu. No, this is actually a Daihatsu. I mean, if you take a look from this side, obviously you're gonna say it's a Myvi. Duh, because it looks exactly like a Myvi. Your Myvi came from this. Like, yeah. So this is called a Daihatsu Passo Hana. That's the name of this. And take a look at the interior if you can see it. Yeah. And moving on to the next, we have this is actually one of my friend's car. It's a Produa Viva, which he converted into a Daihatsu car as well. And these guys are all from Street Garage, by the way. Nicely done. Yeah. Oh yeah, so yeah, this is converted into a Daihatsu Mira AV. Yep, that's what it's called in Japan. And in Malaysia it calls it the Produa Myvi, which looks similar to this except for the front end and the insides. I'm not sure if he did the inside as well. Yeah, it looks like he changed it as well. Yep. And what we have here is actually a Produa Asia, which is converted into a Daihatsu as well. Let me show you the front end. Single wiper, why not? This is what a Daihatsu front end looks like, if you guys don't know, which you, most of you all know. Interior wise, still the Produa interior. That's the front and rear. You got the Daihatsu tail lights, the Daihatsu back bumper, and rear wiper delete. I think this car is incomplete yet because it's missing the spoilers and a few emblems. Oh, he has the Daihatsu side view mirror as well. That's interesting. And we have a few Kanchils over here that is also converted to look like a Daihatsu car. Skid rail cars. We have a blue one, we have a green one, we have a white one, and another light green one. So all the event stickers that this guy has been through. Oh yes, rear camera pula, rear curtain. That's nice. Hey, wait. This is two doors. So I don't think so this is a Kanchil. This is actually a Mira. I think, yeah. I might have mistaken this for a Kanchil because I didn't realize it was a two-door. Yeah, nice Japanese plate as well with the Japanese Automotive Federation badges and a full sunroof, moonroof thing, whatever you want to call it. And this one here is a monster. Okay, this one is a Kanchil, but it's a monster, it's a track car. Looks like a time attack car. Look at the splitters, the white body kit for aero. No interior as usual. I think that's the nitrous battery, the gauges and all that. Yeah, you can't see that. Caged up, massive wing for downforce. Look at the exhaust. Wow. I mean, this is nice. I like this. Okay, maybe over here you can see the inside a bit. There. And we have a bunch of Subaru rally team race cars over here. If I'm not mistaken, that is what you call a wagon or what. Okay, so we're just gonna go one by one. This is from Entera Motorsports and it has all the liveries. Just like a Subaru rally car. Nice, the wing, the wheels and all that. It even has a roof scoop. I'm not sure it's functional or not. Could be. And we have the so this is the Blob Eye and this is Eagle Eye or Evo Eye, I'm not really too sure. And what's interesting is that it has like a GoPro mount over here. So you can just put your GoPro camera in there and just record. If you're rallying in Malaysia lah, don't know where you want to rally, but you can rally lah. It has a huge wing. The different from that one. This one is a bit more bigger and has that line thingy inside. And it has a wide body as well. I think it's molded in. And a front white fender. The livery is also, it gives out the rally look. We have another one over here, which I believe is a complete race car. It has the seatbelt harness, racing seat caged up, and some fighter jet switches to start on the car, kill switch, and all those kind of things. And yeah, this is the wagon version it thing. And we have another one over here. Yeah, this is also a race car version, I believe. It has the GoPro mount as well, the camera mount to record all of your rallying and upload on YouTube to get some views. And yeah, so this is the same. It has the gauges, the steering wheel, and the steering wheel has a multimedia button on it, so you can listen songs while you're flying on the road. That's nice. Right, let's go in now. Alright, so it's kind of loud in here. Not sure if you can hear me. But we are starting off with this madness of a build right here, which is a Mitsubishi Triton or a Pajero. It has the supercharged blower right in front and also its turbo. So I'm not really too sure what's going on over here, what madness is this. The clear hood so that you can see everything inside. And this is on air suspension, custom front end, everything. Everything is custom on this car. There's nothing, factory or whatever. carbon fiber wheelbarrows, carbon fiber door, carbon fiber seats. You have clean nitrous tank in there. And also you have the air suspension tanks at the back. I think that's air suspension tanks or more NOS. A huge, aggressive, wide body rear fender. And you also have the front old fenders as well. Alright, a few more Subarus. And this is Subaru Impreza WRX Type RA STI version limited.
Wow.
Okay. So, I don't think so. Anything is done to this car. It's like it is as it is. It has a little. I'm not really too sure what you call that, but okay. And we have the STI version 11. It looks real good in the blue. I mean, Subaru blue is just awesome.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you're having a good time.
And yeah, manual transmission. So I think this is our stock. Stock wheels, factory wheels. And we have the Forester STI as well. So I believe this is all the, like, you know, all the new cars. All the showroom cars, they're just selling it and they're displaying what you can do to it. And check this out, we have a huge ass monster truck right behind us. Look at the wheels. It's all custom. Obviously it's custom made lah, takkan nak keluar dari gudang macam ni gila apa. This is from Thailand, yep. Right, so these cars actually, these trucks came from Thailand. So they crossed the border and then they load up into a trailer and came over to this event. So let me just show you. Obviously you have the front disc brakes over here. Custom make every single thing. All of this suspension, everything, just to lift up the truck to fit all these big ass tires. And this thing drives, this thing drives. It's just not for show, it actually drives. Not sure the size of it though. Yeah, the back part of it, the rear differential, axles, whatever things you want to call it. Don't. Yeah, I know I'm wrong most of the things. And
all these in the house. Oh yes.
Oh my god. This is as tall as I am. Look at that, my shoulder. Like my shoulder height. So huge. So huge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cover up some video coverage first and then I'll go around again to take the pictures. So let's take you guys around first. Nice light blue Subaru WRX. I like it. I like the color. Going on over there, but I'm trying to scream into the phone right now. I'm putting it close to my mouth so that I can hear. Okay, so yeah, this blue on the Subaru. I'm not sure if it's blue or what do you call this? Cyan. Okay, now I don't have to shout. Okay, now I have to shout again. And it has a C28, I think the 10 spokes or the 8 spokes. I'm not too sure. That's nice. Another Subaru. This is one of my favorites. This version is one of my favorites. Carbon fiber hood. This is not T37s, don't get fooled with that. Rally side view mirrors, the rally style ones. Okay, carbon fiber wing, huge. Ooh, look at the paint. So this is not black. I think, I mean, it's black, but it has the glitter in it to give that bedazzle look. I love this model. And we have the classic Forester. Carbon fiber hood as well. A nice I have no idea what to call this color, but it is nice. And this one is also running a C28 rims as well. And yeah, sunroof. Nice wing at the back. Damn, looks nice. That date was. Okay, this is the one of the other Subarus, which is also my favorite in the line. And this is, yeah, this one, this is one of my favorites. This model has a nice grayish look on it. We have the neon green Subaru. I'm not sure this is a wrap or a paint, because most of the cars, they go for wrap nowadays because it's much more easier. And yeah, that's a wrap. Okay guys, that's a wrap. Thank you so much for watching. Okay, and we have an XV over here, Subaru XV, with a huge Brembo brakes at the front, and it's also slammed, lowered to the ground. And we have one more over here that looks like a Mercedes. Actually, I'm not sure what was the look that he was going through, but it looks like a Mercedes, but it is a Subaru. And a cute little GT wing to add more downforce to it. Nicely done, yellow color. Another XV? Yeah, this is XV as well. That was the neon green. And we have another one more over here. This is, I think, built mostly performance-wise. You see the front splitter, canards, white body, matte black. We have the classic blue Subarus. More XVs on the side. That is... I have no idea what model is that. This one is also look like it's tracked, because it's built, it has everything, all the white body and all that. So is this. I'm not sure which white body is this, Veris or... Yeah, it looks like a Veris body kit. Oh, I love Subarus. Moving on over here, more Subarus as well. All the same bluish colors. Not bluish, like I'm a blue, so I'm just yapping everything out of my mouth right now, so excuse me. The original Subaru wheels, same goes to this one. So this one is a bit different, that one is a bit different design, the wheels, but it's all the original Subaru ones, and all in Subaru blue except for that one over there. This guy is also rocking the CE28. So is this guy using the CE28. And he has a Voltex wing, carbon fiber parts on it. Front end is all fully carbon fiber. And this one, he doesn't have a rear wing. And he has that thing. I'm not sure what do you even call this. Anyone knows what they call this? It's not a roof scoop or sunroof or whatever. I'm not sure what is it called. And the purpose of it, if you guys know, just let me know. Don't hate me, but just let me know what this is for. And oh, this is one of my favorites as well, the hatchback version. I think this is version 9 if I'm not mistaken. And last we have this version of Subaru, which is completely stock, I believe. Doesn't have any mods done. And we have the madness of a Mitsubishi Evo over here, wide body. This is a paint, not wrap. Don't be mistaken, this is a paint. It's not wrap. Okay. It was done from this brand, Aika. So let me just walk you around to it, okay? So if you can see the front here, looks glossy, right? It looks shiny, glossy. So if you go to the side, starting from the fenders, it's already like matte. It's still the same chameleon color, but it's just transformed to from gloss to matte. Okay, so you see, it's real paint, soft matte. And it has carbon fiber bits as well, carbon fiber rear wing, ducktail, diffuser, and boot as well. It has a go-kart that matches the car color. And look at the roof is so beautiful. Glittering. Nicely done interior. The gauges are matched to the car color as well. And also the shifter circle thingy down there. We have another Evo over here in yellow. Built engine, I believe. Carbon fiber, splitter, bumper stuff, canards, hood. Also C28 again. Clean build, I believe, yeah. And this is also a paint, not a wrap. Ductile carbon fiber, diffuser, it's also carbon fiber. And we have a Monster R32 GTR or a non-GTR, I'm not really too sure. Has a wide body fenders, carbon fiber. And is there anything done in the interior except for a carbon fiber dash? I believe it's air suspension because it has the controls over there. It has like an Android player thingy. But yeah, looks damn good. We have a R35 here with a carbon fiber hood, white body kit. And this is on air suspension. I'm not too sure if this is painted or wrapped. And he has the exhaust shooting out from the number plate area. Normally it's down here, right? So he just custom make everything and it's just shooting out from the number plate area with a massive wing at the back. And we have a 300ZX in the house. Now you don't see this much. It's actually the first time I'm seeing it at an event, actually. And 300ZX are one of my favorites as well. And this is rocking the whale side body kit, if I'm not mistaken. This is a whale side body kit on this car. And that is definitely, I think, a whale side rims as well. Yep, whale side. Nicely done. I love this. And next to it, he has a S15 with Nismo wheels on it. And I believe this is a fully built SR20 engine. Blue valve cover. Nicely done. Almost fell onto the car over there. And we have a Fairlady Z, one of my favorite Fairlady Z's ever made. This is one of my favorite. I really love this Fairlady a lot because of the body line, and look at it. It looks like an American muscle car, but it's a Japanese car. And we have a Toyota Supra with TC105 and TC105X wheels with a splitter, white body kit, and a massive rear wing as well. And moving on to the back, we have a aggressive diffuser, which I believe that exhaust is a straight pipe exhaust. Okay, it's going to be very difficult to hear me from now on, so I'm just going to be a bit loud. And we have a Super Trofeo wide body Huracan, and that lady is leaning onto the car, which you're not supposed to do because it's not your car, and please don't lean on people's car.
Yeah, pemenang kita.
Yellow wheels, crazy wrap.
Dan itulah akhirnya kita
menang. Looks like a Super Trofeo though.
Alright, okay, bang, masih bang. So kita ada lagi game. Kita ada.
Okay, so we have a white body Ferrari F430 here with a bit of carbon fiber bits and pieces. This is, I believe, yeah, this is painted. And we have, oh my god, look at this exhaust setup. This is crazy, louder than your girlfriend last night, obviously. How can your girlfriend be louder than this car? Obviously this car is going to be screaming. Alright, I'm going to get the hell out of this part because it's too noisy. See you guys in a bit. We have an S15, which is also on air suspension. This was at the Motomaniac Rebound event. And we have a Nando Grey 350Z, which I believe that is the owner because he's wiping down the car, duh. And it's also an S1 suspension. We have a Porsche. Guys, please don't touch the cars. Please don't touch the car side display. Please do not touch the cars. Why are your hands so itchy to touch the cars? So simple. Look with your eyes, not with your hands. This is done by J White Body Kit as well. It has a custom white body kit. I'm not too sure which type of body kit is this. Rocket Bunny, Liberty Walk, Panda, or whatever. And we have a yellow 350C on a suspension as well. Most of these cars, or almost all of these cars, are all under a suspension. A forged carbon fiber look on the rear wing, and it has like a cover for the... What is going on over there? I'm not really sure. And we have another white body, 350Z. Looks cool. Yellow. Double yellow. We have an NSX as well, which is also on a suspension. And what I like about this NSX, it has a rear wing which is huge, and it also has a custom exhaust setup. That's cool. Okay, moving on to the next. We have a BMW. We have a Supra, I mean a BMW Z4. We have a BMW Z4 with the OZ wheels and a massive Brembo front brakes and also rear brakes. It also have a big ass rear wing with a diffuser and the Aquapoise exhaust. We have Need for Speed Underground 2 350Z. And yeah, this is built pretty nicely. We have a frog in front of it. Vinyl frog. Is this? I think I know whose car it is. Yeah. This is that TikTok famous girl's car. What? Sharina, I believe. Yeah, yes, it is her car, yes. You can see it, Richie. Yeah, this is a 350Z, also known as, nicknamed as Bobo. Oh yeah, she did change this to the rap. I didn't know that. That's nice. Ooh, this is interesting. A mafia style gangster murdered out BMW. Alamak, dia tak pergi ambil gambar lah. Shit. Macam mana ni? Is this a 7 series? I guess so. Lowered, slammed. Slammed lifestyle. Scraped to the ground while the sparks fly out on the road lifestyle. Two-tone color lifestyle. We have a Toyota 86. And we have a Mazda. I know the owner. I mean, I know the owner's Instagram. It's a girl. She had a Myvi. I don't even know. She still have the Myvi, the red color Myvi. And this is her car as well. Her car as well, which is also an air suspension, I believe so. All these cars are air suspension, so this is also an air suspension. This Toyota Corolla is also an air suspension. This Monster Mustang GT is also an air suspension. With a clear hood to see the engine bay and that sausage intake. Candy red, which is my favorite color of all time. We have a huge, massive wing. Oh yeah, forgot to mention out, it's also on white body. Duh. Okay. And we have this owner, the owner's ECG thing as well. I think it's the owner's one, I'm not too sure, just simply saying that. And we have a massive wing. And we have that I don't even know that, what does it do?
Whoa, look at the interior.
Okay,
of this car.
So we have,
I didn't see the roof line like this. It looks
from
a bit
literally
like
Disney, Pixar,
oh,
the cars.
Oh my goodness. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have not been
I forgot
inside
this character's
the
name.
Rolls Royce Phantom,
We have Lightning the Queen, the roof, right? And we have another version of Lightning the Queen is super duper rare, under Dinoco.
But we have something close as a Rolls-Royce Phantom with the interior being literally super, exactly super luxurious with the rooftop.
And
the
guys, the green sky, you can't even buy this stuff.
The sky of stars. This rooftop
literally like one of one, exactly like Lightning the Queen. Custom make, everything is custom. I'm not sure what the original car was.
You can go closer and have a look at the interior. Wow, everything on this car has been customized. So I believe this is one of the event sponsors, Carzone Interior.
But check that out.
They are specialized in doing exactly.
And these cars are all from Thailand.
Modifying and customizing Thailand. Your interior to however and whatever you ever imagined.
Not
your car.
Sure what
wow,
car
so ladies and gentlemen, originally, once again, what this did car they made it is from? A special sponsor by Carzone Interior.
Check out the
interior of this MG Cruiser. I could not recognize it at all. That is how much customization has been done. Alright, check this out. Show some love. This is really, really amazing. Khalis, I think we have one more slot for something very special. Please, okay? This is one of the main attractions here. Xin Jing, right? Yeah, she's here as well.
I think it with looks like a Supra though. All these cars look like Supra, okay, so, Mark 4.
Well, it's not so much about
I think these are all Mark 4 Supras except
about,
for the blue one. The blue one is something else.
RX-7 MB3
and a Ventador.
Right, because I have a very cool piece
in
to show you.
Nardo greyish color. I love the body kit that he has.
This is an RX-7
fiber extension on it.
It looks like a Porsche.
It doesn't, yeah. So apparently, well, those lights
we have a lot of other carbon fiber bits as well. This one over here.
This
we have the wing,
the
and we have this interesting GTR, which I've seen on TikTok.
I've never seen it right here. Malaysia,
another louder than your girlfriend sticker.
But I just
don't care.
Found out that they've only
and actually, this is it's like an active aero.
Yes. So this
can go
very,
up and down. Basically, this wing.
Well, the RX-7,
so you can control it from so you can go up and down. It moves.
Rotary,
you can see the mechanism over
people
there.
People go crazy for these things, but RBVVR is one of those high-end brands that people
and
love for the RX-7. It's got its own following. Yeah?
Oh my
color,
goodness,
the color
I've never known.
Right.
Thank
like,
you so much
like
for letting us know.
But I have a very cool piece, so
side.
As you can
it's
see
like,
right here.
It's like damn nice, I love this color. What is this?
But on this particular car, there's no door handles.
So how do you open it?
That's the thing. So that's what I want to show you guys.
It's
right
interesting
here.
Because I've never
so
seen an RX 7 like this before. And these guys were just informing that this is the RA Yamamiya body kit, which transformed the front of it. Were these guys trying to look for a Porsche look or something? You could have bought a Porsche instead.
2, 1. There we have it.
My dude.
Check out the doors.
My goodness.
No way.
Now, for most people who follow cars or like cars and JDMs, doing this kind of conversion is a bit of a blasphemy, isn't it?
Yeah, because for me to enter the car, I need to wait about 15 seconds. But
yeah, imagine if you're rushing to somewhere and you have to wait.
It's actually made for show, but Khalis, why is it so special to have a door like this with this function on its other side?
Well, this particular car, RBVVR, has had the ideology that they want to do something a little bit different. So in Japan, the way they do cars, the way they do things are a bit crazy. And this is one of those crazy
build.
Outside, they tend to not really accept it as much. But looking at this, I mean, yeah, a lot of people out there who do it with like mirrors, IVs and all that, and they get a lot of shit for it, but when the Japanese people do it, well, it's cool, isn't it?
Yeah. I don't think they get as much because it's an RX-7 at the end of the day.
Yeah, so
yeah,
if you look at
what he just said,
this
guy is if you do it in a local car, everyone give a lot of shit, but if you do it in other cars, like Japanese cars, people seem to like it. That's weird. But, so we're gonna leave these guys alone, they're gonna go and move on somewhere else. And well, I kinda tried to, like, you know, cover the whole area, but there's just too many people. Not too many people, it's like people are just constantly touching the cars and all that. I mean, guys, if you go to this kind of auto shows, please don't touch the cars. I mean, the models, they are paid to do it, so you guys and your kids and all that are just whacking their hands on the car and all that, which could cause damage. And yeah, so basically, already covered the event. not as much, but I tried to. It was too loud with the music. I tried to speak as loud as I could, but I tried my level best. So right now we're gonna go home. We're gonna go home and we're gonna sleep. Thank you so much guys for tuning in, and if you stayed until the end of the video, please do. I mean, if you don't even stay so lah until the end of the video, logic sikit lah bang, eh. I'm sweating. Please do like and subscribe to my channel, to this video. Please share this video with your friends, even though they don't watch it or what, even though they find it boring, whatever. Please just do. Show me some support, man. Just like how you support all the other celebrities and all the other YouTube channels that you watch, please do the same for me as well, so that in that way I can grow and create more content, go out more for events, and yeah. So thank you guys again. Once more, my English is breaking into some other language, I don't know what it is. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and enjoy your weekend. I shall spend sports. Screw it. I'm not gonna say anything.